Hello everyone, my name is Gauri Maheshwari. I work as Assistant Professor in Department of Civil Engineering at SCAD College of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to today's technical webinar on Constructed Wetland Nutrient Removal Technology. This technical webinar is organized by Department of Civil Engineering, SCAD College of Engineering and Technology. SCAD College of Engineering and Technology, Cheran Mahadevi Tirunelveli, is an offshoot of SCAD Social Change and Development, a socially committed group which has been doing immense service in uplifting the deprived lot of the southern region since 1985. The college follows a high-end teaching practice to impart curriculum to make its students understand the nuances of engineering and technology and master the skills with a high degree of discipline and order. Conducive learning with webinars make the students get updated with the emerging trends of technology and stand tall with their global counterparts. Is to be handled by Dr. S. Gopi Kumar. I am pleased to introduce today's resource person, Dr. S. Gopi Kumar. He is working as an associate professor in Department of Civil Engineering at SCAD College of Engineering and Technology, Tirunelveli. He completed B.Tech Chemical Engineering in 2006 at Adhyaman Engineering College, Oshur. M.E. Environmental Engineering in 2009 at Government College of Technology, Coimbatore. And Ph.D. in 2015, thesis on enhancement of anaerobic digestion potential in waste-activated sludge by biological pretreatment. He has teaching experience for 7 years and research experience of 4 years. And he is an unanimously recognized research supervisor in Department of Civil Engineering 2020. He has done 2 funded projects, one for TNSCST and other for DST. We are delighted to welcome Dr. S. Gopi Kumar to this technical webinar. Before I hand the session over to Dr. S. Gopi Kumar, I have few housekeeping items to cover about this presentation and SCATS and Civil Technical Webinar platform. Today's webinar will be available on demand after the live session and is accessible through the same link you are using now. Next, we would love to hear from you during today's presentation. If you have a question for our speaker, please feel free to send it through the YouTube live chat box. We will be answering the question at the end of the session. If we don't get to your question during today's webinar, we will be sure to follow up afterward. And last, we would like to encourage you to share today's webinar with your social networks. You can use the social sharing icons at the top right corner of your player to post this webinar directly on Twitter, Facebook, or LinkedIn. Dear participants, don't forget to click the subscription button to get further updates of SCATSET Civil. An important reminder, participants, please stay connected till the end of the session. Feedback form link will be posted in the YouTube live chat box at the end of the session. So, without any further ado, I'd like to kick things off by welcoming our beloved resource person, Dr. S. Gopi Kumar. Over to you, sir.
Welcome to the live webinar. And today's topic is Constructed Wetland Nutrient Removal Technology. And let us discuss about the World Health Organization and UNICEF's report. Recently, they have revealed that 3 out of 10 are in need of fresh drinking water and 6 are lacking secure sanitation. And we know that population is getting increased and municipal corporation is giving 136 liter per capita day of water for every individual. And out of this, 80% is converted as wastewater. Wastewater is treated. Yes, it is partially treated or directly move on to natural resources. Actually happens is the wastewater is taken into the natural wetland. What is natural wetland? Natural wetlands are the it acts as Earth's kidney. The natural wetlands acts as Earth's kidney. The process takes place is the world largest natural wetland implemented in Calcutta. The entire plant covers 2 districts. And now some of the natural wetlands in India are displayed. And let us in terms about wastewater. As wastewaters are the water generated from home, industry and business units. Whether the wastewater is a burden or resource, we can say that it is burden if it contains excess amount of, but the real fact is night is resource. And what is wastewater treatment? It is the process of removal of contaminant using a reactor. And how we are going to transform the wastewater is collected in a reservoir and it is purified and used for drinking purpose. And recycle is the wastewater which is processed and then used for domestic purpose such as cleaning, washing. As these are the mode where the burden can be rectified. And considering a proper treatment method, there are some basic fundamentals are there, such as engineered technological approach is essential, social acceptability is essential, and financial support for organizing or getting a treatment is must. And apart from that, environmental sustainability is the major factor. Now let us discuss about the conventional wastewater approach. And this is the classical method where it has been followed for 100 decades. In this case, the collected wastewater is stored in a collection tank. It is the first phase. And then it is passed on to anaerobic reactor. Anaerobic reactor, in this case, mixing is processed. Mixing is carried out through flow equalization, with change in flow rate is developed, and followed by anaerobic, aerobic reactor is attached, where diffused aerators are in the reactor, where through electric supply aeration is given. And the next phase is secondary clarifier, where the effluent treated water is expelled out and the sludge collected is again returned to the anaerobic tank. And this processing is called return activated sludge processing. And in this classical method, enormous amount of sludge is generated, and processing this sludge is a major task. And the methods introduced in sludge processing are thickening, stabilization, conditioning, dewatering and volume reduction. And in all these phases, the moisture content and water content are removed. And finally, in volume reduction, it is converted as hollow blocks, or it is used for modern construction materials, and it is directly taken to sanitary landfill. And need for modern approach, as classical methods shows some lacunas, and those are: a proper optimizing efficiency is not analyzed, and then higher cost, high energy consumption, and this method cannot be used in large scale operation. So we are in need of a modern environmental friendly technique. And this is artificial engineered constructed wetland, and one of the modern method. And this engineered system is constructed, the function is duplicating the process of natural wetland. And in most part of our country, this artificial engineered constructed wetland is still in practice. And this photograph is implemented in Ireland in UCD School of Civil Engineering. Constructed wetlands practiced in India, in more Madhya Pradesh and in Tamil Nadu, this constructed wetland method is followed. And let us distinct parameters. First of all, vegetation plays major role, and in this case, macrophytes, free floating, emergent and submerged plants are used for effective treatment. And then the flow pattern, free water surface flow, subsurface flow, horizontal and vertical flow are to be practiced. And the system configuration, hybrid or multi-stage system. And type of wastewater to be treated is essential. The influent and effluent chambers, biofilters may be attached, which is considered as pre-treatment. And the types of substrates such as gravel, soil and sand plays major role in identifying the efficiency. And depends on wastewater, the loading is finalized. Let's see the classification of constructed wetland. It is primarily classified as free surface flow wetland. And in this free surface flow, the macrophyte, the vegetation plays major role. Emergent plant, submerged plant, free floating plant, floating leaf plant. Simultaneously, subsurface flow wetlands are there. It is classified as vertical flow wetland, horizontal flow wetland, hybrid constructed wetland, where the hybrid constructed wetland comprises of both vertical flow and horizontal flow. Vertical flow wetland, it is classified as upflow, downflow and tidal flow. Now, constructed wetland mechanism. The major mechanisms involved in treatment are adsorption, filtration, hydrolysis, biodegradation, bioaccumulation, phytoremediation, photoremediation. And this is one of the typical horizontal flow constructed wetland, where this is the first constructed wetland treatment unit in India. It is implemented in 1995 in Bhubaneswar, where the gives priority in this treatment method. And this model is implemented in Indonesia with bamboo. And now, vertical flow constructed wetland. And in this case, the wastewater is allowed to store in a higher zone. It is collected in an overhead tank, or it may be pumped from layer, and the flow from lower region. Some of examples were given. The hybrid constructed wetland model comprises or incorporate both the vertical and horizontal filters. In this case, the wastewater is allowed to store in a higher zone, overhead tank, and then it is passed on to the vertical filter and then to horizontal filter, finally emitted out. These are models. Some of the factors determining the treatment process are clogging, pH and temperature. Where loading of wastewater is solids is larger, diluted, and the treatment may be progressed. It's one of the factor where in both the influent and effluent entrance and exit, precipitation takes place. Due to excessive minerals and nutrients, precipitation takes place, and this minerals will make the hydraulic flow in time period. So it should be avoided. And pH should be in the range of 6 to 9, where the bacterial growth and vegetation growth are effective. Here in microbial growth and biological activity enhances in this temperature. Now, some advantages of this constructed wetland model, where these models are natural process and simple to construct, simple operation and cost effective, and throughout the time period the process is stable. And coming to limitations, land, as if we have land, economical. Now success rate in adopting this technology: domestic sewage treatment units, landfill leachate management, sugar industry, lake, river water treatment are progressed through this wetland model. Now let us move on to nutrient removal method, where biological nutrient removal, this process is removing nitrogen and phosphorus in wastewater is discharged into wastewater. Theory reveals that 3 to 5 grams of nitrogen is removed during 100 grams removal of COD. And in this method, the predominant minerals removed are nitrogen and phosphorus. Now let us come into the conventional system, how biological nutrient is removed in conventional system. As in the previous slides we discussed that conventional classical method comprises of sedimentation and then return activated sludge returning. In this case, the first mixing tank, in this tank denitrification process is progressed. By modifying the configuration and process range. Sequential batch reactor. The sequential batch reactor is worked under the principle of conventional activated sludge treatment method. A single reactor is used. Reactor, 5 steps of process were carried out: fill, react, settle, decant and idle. Process carried out with varying time period. As the wastewater is allowed to fill in the tank and aeration is supported, then allowed to finally it is removing, decanted and then keeping the reactor idle, and further the flow is. And this works under the principle of CIS, nutrient removal process in SBR method. In this case, the photograph image shows how aeration is given, as aeration plays predominant role in mixing the reactor. One more predominant thing in biological removal is enhancing nitrification process, denitrification process, phosphorus removal process, by making the reactor separated as 3 phase: aerobic, anaerobic and anoxic phase. The SBR type model, first filling is given. In this filling, where denitrification process is enhanced, mixing, aeration is supported and nitrification process takes place, where nitrification is an oxygen hungry process. After aeration, in mixing phase, denitrification again progressed. Finally, post sedimentation and effluent removal. And this is the nutrient removal process in SBR method. Now let us discuss how phosphorus is removed and nitrogen is removed in various reactors. Phosphorus is removed through biological method. Phosphorus is removed using anoxic oxic reactor. And through biological process, nitrogen and phosphorus are removed through various anoxic oxic reactor, Baden-Powell reactors. Simultaneously, simultaneously, phosphorus is removed through chemical processes by using metal salts and lime. Again, phosphorus is removed through hybrid method such as phosphate BCFS. And now let us discuss about the fundamentals of nitrogen removal. Both the nutrients, biological nutrients, are removed in anaerobic reactor. The first diagram shows that in anaerobic phase, in the absence of are selected, and this accumulated organisms are used for fermentation. Mostly in anaerobic reactor, heterotrophic bacteria are developed. This heterotrophic bacteria uptakes PAOs from volatile fatty acids and phosphorus is removed. The bacteria, heterotrophic bacteria, is uptaking phosphorus accumulating organisms. And now anoxic reactor followed by anaerobic anoxic. The anoxic phase in a pond or reactor is developed by making the reactor half anaerobic and half aerobic. This is the term anoxic represents. And in this case, denitrification process develops and enhances in aerobic phase, followed by alkalinity production, selection of denitrifying bacteria. Similar to anaerobic phase, in anoxic phase, denitrifying bacteria, the heterotrophic bacteria, develops. And this bacteria converts nitrate to nitrogen gas. And then nitrogen is removed in anoxic phase. Now let us move on to aerobic phase. In aerobic phase, in oxygen phase, both nitrogen is removed and phosphorus is removed. Nitrification in two stages are used to remove nitrogen. Simultaneously, phosphorus accumulating organisms . This is all about how nitrogen and phosphorus is removed in biological phase. On to nutrient removal mechanism. As suspended solids is settling process, it is physical process, and the suspended solids alone separated using biodegradation process, and BOD is removed using settling, oxidation and biodegradation. All these processes are carried out in the constructed wetland. Now hydrocarbons such as fuels, oil, grease, pesticides, all those hydrocarbons are removed using physical methods such as diffusion, volatilization and settling. Simultaneously, chemical process used in this phase is photochemical oxidation. And biological method used to remove hydrocarbons are biodegradation, phytodegradation, phytovolatilization, evapotranspiration. Now let us move on to nitrogenous compounds and phosphoric compounds. And the nitrogen settling, as settling is a physical process. Now biological method, biodenitrification and nitrification are used to remove nitrogen. Plant uptake nitrogen. And phosphorus removal is carried out through settling in physical phase, and by adding chemicals, precipitation and adsorption takes place. Using biological method, microbes are used to uptake simultaneously. Metals are used by the process settling, precipitation, phytoaccumulation. Now let us move on to the metals available in waste: aluminium, arsenic, cadmium, chromium, copper, iron, lead, manganese, nickel, selenium, silver and zinc. Now how the reactor is monitored? Fluorate, influent and effluent fluorate are to be monitored periodically. This daily monitoring is essential. And parameter such as BOD, COD, suspended solids, pH dissolved oxygen is to be monitored weekly once. Let us move on to this nitrogen fixation. As nitrogen fixation is the process where the atmospheric nitrogen by the plant roots and nitrogen is getting fixed. In this case, the molecular nitrogen, atmospheric molecular nitrogen N2 is converted into ammonia, and this process is carried out by cyanobacteria and autotrophic bacteria. Graphic image shows that the green color phase shows the cyanobacteria availability. And now let us move on to ammonification. Ammonification is the process where animals are decomposed, dead plants and animals are decomposed, and it is utilized by soil bacteria, and this soil bacteria converts the dead decomposed material into ammonia, NH3, and further the ammonia is converted into ammonium, NH4. This process is ammonification. So we have discussed nitrogen fixation, ammonification. Now volatilization. This process is where the ammonium, through ammonification process we get ammonium, and this ammonium is converted into ammonia as gas, and this process is volatilization. These three processes, nitrogen fixation, ammonification, volatilization, takes place in nitrogen removal process. Now let us move on to nitrification, the oxygen hungry process, and this takes place in two steps. First one, the ammonium NH4 is oxidized into nitrite NO2, and then further oxidization leads to nitrate NO3, and this is the simple process, nitrification, where the ammonium is converted into nitrate, major nitrification. And the bacteria used were ammonium oxidizing bacteria and nitrogen oxidizing bacteria. And in nitrification phase, the bacteria used were homogeneous bacteria. Now let us move on to denitrification. As heterotrophic bacteria were used, and this denitrification takes place in anaerobic zone where heterotrophic bacteria are used, and it works under anaerobic phase. And in this case, the nitrate NO3 is reduced to NO2, nitrite, and then nitrite is further reduced to nitric oxide. Oxide NO is further reduced to nitrous oxide, and then nitrous oxide is reduced to nitrogen gas and emitted to atmosphere. And this is the simple denitrification process, where the photographic image of denitrification is clearly explained in image, where anaerobic phase soil take up ammonia and it is converted as nitrogen. And now of constructed wetland treating wastewater. Now the image clearly shows that the relation between plants, substrate, microbes. Move on to the functions of individuals. Microbes function. Let us first discuss about microbes function, where in this case absorbs ions for growth. Ammonium nitrogen nitrification takes place. Nitrate nitrogen denitrification takes place, and COD degradation takes place with the support of microbes. Now functions. Function of substrate. Substrate is nothing but the wetland gravel. The functions were absorbs ions, phosphate ions were absorbed by the gravel sand. Of plants, The vegetation absorbs ions for growth and it absorbs water and nutrients. Let's discuss about the interaction among microbes to substrate, where the bacterial microbes gravel it is used for rapid microbial growth, porosity decrease, substrate blocking. These are the prime factors. Now, substrate to microbe interaction in this case provide surface for microbe biofilm to adhere, slow decrease organic carbon. Let's move on to interaction among substrate and plants. The relation between gravel, sand and plants. Roots will grow well, fill pores, substrate blocking, change water flow and release chemical, substrate erosion and porosity is decreased. Now, substrate to plant relation is provide support. The relation among plants and microbes. In this case, microbes to plant relation shows that mutualism provide vitamins, and in terms of plant to microbes interaction provide rhizosphere where root releases oxygen, and all these parameters are further explained clearly. And now let us discuss about the factors in temperature, oxygen, water flow rate, nutrient loading rate, and the amount of water retained in the reactor. And a typical reactor image is shown here. Now, let us move on to physical process of where the biological process supported by physical method. Clearly shows the inflow of wastewater. The plant uptake all the resources, minerals in the soil, and in this case the two phases were clearly shown, where aerobic zone in the surface and anaerobic zone in the bottom layer. In this case, where through decomposition carbon dioxide is emitted and volatilization is enhanced, ammonia is emitted as gas, hydrogen sulfide is emitted, and vitrification process nitrogen gas is also emitted, where nitrate is there. And in anaerobic phase, in wetland phase, the soil storage, burial or due to dead plants, the soil storage, all the decomposed compositions are precipitated. Further, the which is biological process of nutrient removal. And this image clearly shows how nitrification takes place, denitrification takes place. Initially, from influent, nitrate and polyphosphates are coming through influent, and it is as nitrogen and phosphorus, and both nitrogen and phosphorus are uptake by plant roots. Decomposition is zone where the dead plants in the living plant, where NH4 ammonia is converted to nitrite and then nitrate. This process is nitrification, and then from nitrate NO3 N2 is emitted, and this process is denitrification. And both the process, nitrification and denitrification, is used to remove nitrogen. Now let us move on to nitrogen process in wetland, and this image clearly shows the quantum amount of water inflow and amount of water emitted out, and the layers were clearly separated. Anaerobic layer is shown, aerobic layer is shown, and the process involved in this image clearly shows adsorption. In the bottom layer, adsorption, ammonium is adsorbed. It is a reversible process, and ammonification process, immobilization process, it is shown, and diffusion takes place, where diffusion is sorption process, where both absorption and adsorption takes place in this phase. And in the aerobic zone, nitrification process develops, and due to nitrification, nitrate is evolved, and with denitrification, nitrogen gas is evolved, and nitrogen fixing process takes place using algae. Volatilization is evolved, aeration, oxygen support is given. So this image clearly shows how nitrogen process takes place in wetland. Now let us move on to the transformation cycle. As bacteria mediate chemical reaction, and microbes are found on solid surfaces. Litter, submerged plants, stems and leaves. The cycle, transformation cycle, depends on discussed ammonification, nitrification, denitrification. And this image clearly shows how nitrogen cycle works in wetland model. Image, the first phase, N2 is fixing is given, and volatilization, ammonia is emitted as gas, and nitrification and denitrification process takes place in aerobic and anaerobic zone, and nitrogen gas is emitted out again. As in inlet, N2 is given to air, and in outlet, N2 is emitted in using nitrification, denitrification, phosphorus is removed. Now wetland root, as let us discuss about the role of roots, as it link nitrogen load to the surface of wetland soil. In the image, let us see about this, where oxygen is emitted out through the roots, and nitrate, nitrous oxide are uptake by the roots. And this is the simple process, as we are telling that how plant roots absorbs nitrogen. As nitrogen in the form of nitrate, nitrous oxide, the roots are absorbing and emitting out oxygen. And in the image, it is clearly shown N2 is emitted out through leaves, and through surface layer, nitrous oxide is emitted out. And typical image of plant roots are shown. Now let us move on to wetland biota. Wetland biota determines the entire life of plants. In this case, both nutrients are utilized by wetland, nitrogen and phosphorus. Both are utilized by wetland, where the assimilated nutrients are released back into the water. And when the plants grow old, 10 to 20% of nutrients remain in it, and it is settled down and it is absorbed in the soil. In this case, the effect of nitrogen addition by the plant roots and plant uptake is given clearly, where ammonium nitrate in the oxic zone, anoxic zone, with the support of roots, this ammonium is converted into nitrate, and then nitrate is finally emitted out as methane, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, nitrous oxide. And this is all about the gaseous emission. Removed through two phase of work, physical and chemical process, where the physical process takes place through particulate form and dissolved form. And this phosphorus cycle clearly explains in the inflow, in the runoff atmospheric deposition, DIP, where dissolved inorganic phosphorus is coming in the aerobic zone and finally it is circulated. Now it is clearly visible that in aerobic phase and anaerobic phase, where in both the cases, in aerobic particulate phosphorus is taken and in anaerobic phase absorption takes place. And as it clearly shows in slide, where the vegetation is allowing particles, where phosphorus enters wetlands attached to suspended material, and this suspended materials is in two form. In soil it occurs as particulate and in dissolved form phosphate. Let us move on to dissolved form of phosphorus. As the image shows that phosphorus is where the major pore water phosphorus, it is in dissolved form, where processes and plants takes place, organic phosphorus emits out, phosphorus loading is supported to soil pore water, phosphate minerals were deposited in soil. This image where the quantum of water inflow is given, outflow is given, where the reactions, phosphorus based reactions takes place in aerobic layer and anaerobic layer, where organic deposits are settled down. In anaerobic decomposition, sorbed phosphorus, where sorption takes place in two phase, absorption, adsorption. Both the phases takes place in sorption area and dissolved phosphorus is emitted out in anaerobic layer. Aerobic zone, diffusion takes place. And phosphorus content is suspended in the, and it is uptake by algae, as it is clearly represented in image. And coming to the points where the dissolved form of phosphorus occurs as phosphate, it accumulates quickly in sediments by sorption process. Phosphates are in the form of and in terms of hydroxides. And now typical model treating wastewater using the constructed wetland model is implemented, and this model is fabricated in such a way as using hybrid method, where in hybrid both vertical flow and horizontal flow are incorporated along with vegetation. In this case, which comprises V naught square, water dropping baffle and baffle board, packing media, sludge hopper, reactors are incorporated in vertical flow reactor, and four different types of vertical flow reactor are fixed, and the influent water is collected in an anaerobic reactor, and from the anaerobic collection tank wastewater is pumped up and given to the vertical flow reactor and water is allowed to pass through, and all the design parameters are considered, and this method gives an outlet on nitrogen and phosphorus removal, where nitrogen removal takes place around 70 to 90%, where phosphorus removal occurs at 60 to 90%. Where in this case, biological transformation, the process nitrification, denitrification takes place, and using physical methods such as flocculation, sedimentation, filtration takes place, sorption, absorption, adsorption takes place, and ion exchange happens through clay minerals. And the process of phosphorus removal takes place using sedimentation, sorption, and precipitation. And this is a successful model. And some of the keywords to be focused in this constructed wetland models are COD, BOD, BOD, total organic carbon, MLSS, MLVSS, mean cell residence time, waste activated sludge, food to microorganism ratio, settled sludge volume, total suspended solids, volatile suspended solids, and depth of blanket, sludge volume index, nitrate nitrogen, nitrate nitrogen, ammonia nitrogen, and oxygen uptake rate, specific oxygen uptake rate, oxygen reduction potential, and all the parameters are measured in terms of milligram per liter. This method is user friendly and processes nature to nature and operates 7/365 days processing. And acknowledgement, a topic is discussed in this and chapter 2, constructed wetland, an emerging green technology for treatment of industrial wastewater. Yes. And with this, we conclude this webinar session. It's open for questions. Good morning, sir.
It is a very informative session. So there are few questions. There are few questions from the participants.
Okay, sir.
First question is from Muthusalam. What is the purpose of removing nutrients?
You go over, huh? Small the phone, where there?
Sir, what is the purpose of removing the nutrients?
Sir, the purpose of removing nutrient is to prevent eutrophication, as excess nitrogen and phosphorus will growth emerging. All the nutrients might be uptake by this vegetation, which will damage the ecosystem. That is the main root cause.
Okay, sir, thank you. Sir, can you say the importance about the environmental factors in civil engineering?
Some of the major environmental factors: chemical oxygen demand and biological oxygen demand. These are the major factors. water. When the wastewater is polluted with high organic compound, we are using an external chemicals to reduce the deficiency. And similarly, the amount of biological process given to rectify the pollutant. This is the process behind chemical oxygen demand and biological oxygen demand. The term, how it explains is, the amount of chemical given to neutralize the pollutant level. As excess pollutants are available, we are giving additional compound chemicals to neutralize it. Simultaneously, in biological chemical method, the amount of biological compounds given to neutralize the pollution, we have to stabilize it. This is the factors. And these two factors are predominant one. And apart from this, pH. These two parameters plays major role, both for vegetation growth and then microbial activity, as the entire wastewater treatment plant depends on these two factors, maintaining pH level and maintaining proper temperature. And considering one more factor, food to microorganism ratio, F by M ratio, it plays predominant role, as the organic compound, let us consider waste organic compound. Simultaneously, let us consider the sugar industry. It has high glucose content. The amount of organic loading given to the reactor, consider that the reactor has less microorganism. If we are giving excess food, the microorganism can uptake limited food. But excess loading or excess food is given to the reactor, the microbes might become dead cells. So the proper ratio, proper organic loading should be given to the reactor to make the microorganism multiple. With bacterial multiplication, with bacterial stability, with stationary bacterial growth process, only the reactor can sustain. And these are the major factors determining the growth of reactor and determining the efficiency of reactor.
Okay, sir. So the next question from Tamil Selvan, sir. Expected effluent quality and what are its reuse application? How about the pathogen removal efficiency?
Pathogen, the microorganism content are to be removed. That is essential, as the bacterial compositions are heterotrophic, autotrophic. Based on the nature of organisms and based on the role of reactor performance, as whether the reactor might be conventional or sequential or nutrient beneficial reactor, and with this, certain microbes supports the reactor. The rest of the microorganism does not directly influence the reactor performance. So considering the reactor, considering the treatment process and related to that bacteria might be in a development of reactor. Let us consider that in anaerobic reactor, methanogenic bacteria alone is more than sufficient to make the reactor process 99% efficient. Aerobic bacteria to survive in anaerobic reactor. So this is the logic behind utilization of microbes.
Okay, sir. So the next question from Chanakya. Are constructed wetlands applicable for tannery wastewater and aqua wastewater? If so, how can we done?
This constructed wetland model is right now in practice for river water, lake water, aqua water, domestic wastewater treatments. And major works are progressed in sugar industry, distillery industry, dairy industry. considering tannery as it large composition of chromium is available in tannery and high organic loading rate is used. Till experimental work, research work is under progress in this area. As in one of the slide I have mentioned, water treatments are wetland model as tannery under progress.
Okay sir. So next question from Muthusalam. If more calcium in any soil, what will happen in an ecosystem?
Is beneficial. Calcium will not harm the ecosystem, and the calcium compound is uptake in phosphorus accumulating organisms, and normally the calcium will settle down effluent layer of this wetland model, and naturally it causes clogging. So this is the only practical difficulty in settling. And apart from that, it will not affect the process of vegetation or microbial activity.
Okay,
clogging the influent and effluent chamber.
Okay, sir. So the next question is, what is the method used for microorganization removal?
So MPN method is used for microorganism removal. It is one of the biological method. MPN.
Okay, sir. This nutrient removal is same for water treatment or it may vary?
The two type of reactors in this presentation were conventional activated sludge process and sequential batch reactors were involved in nutrient removal. And in this case, in both the reactors, phase change should be developed. How phase change occurs is through making the reactor aerobic, making it anaerobic, making it anoxic zone. These three different zones, nitrogen and phosphorus, are removed. And as in one of the slide, it's clearly shown that in aeration tank, nitrification takes place. In tank, denitrification process takes place. So answer is, in conventional activated sludge method and sequential batch reactor, nutrient.
Okay sir, thank you sir, that's all. Okay, I'm handing on the session to Mr. Surya Prakash for vote of thanks.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself Surya Prakash, CRT from Department of Civil Engineering. It's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this session. I, on behalf of Department of Civil Engineering, SCAD College of Engineering Technology, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to the today's speaker, Dr. S. Gopikumar, Associate Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, SCAD College of Engineering and Technology. We are really honored with your knowledge and presence, sir. I must mention our deep and sense of appreciation for Mrs. R. Sheila Daniel, HOD Civil, and Mr. V. Krishna Shankar, Associate Civil, for organizing, coordinating, and providing technical support to this technical webinar. I especially like Dr. S. Gopikumar, where he talks of water and wastewater technologies involved in treatment, to express my gratitude for Chairman, Vice Chairperson, Managing Director, and Principal, for providing encouragement support. A special thanks to the organizing committee, teaching and non-teaching faculty for the unflinching support and coordination. I heartily congratulate all the participants for this active participation in this event. As no program can become successful with a single person, I extend my big thanks to our department and college for their support, and all our volunteers too. Thank you for making this event successful. And thanks for participating in this event. Thank you.